वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी चैप्टर नंबर 2, ऑपरेशंस ऑन होल नंबर्स। आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू अबाउट होल नंबर्स। व्हाट डू मीन बाय होल नंबर? द नंबर्स 0, 1, 2, 3 एंड सो ऑन आर कॉल्ड द होल नंबर्स। नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एडिशन एज वेल एज सब्ट्रैक्शन। फर्स्ट वील गो हैड विद द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एडिशन। द फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी इज क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी। इसका मतलब ये होता है जब भी आप दो होल नंबर को प्लस करें तो जो आंसर आएगा वो भी होल नंबर होगा। दैट मीन्स द सम ऑफ टू होल नंबर्स इज आल्सो अ होल नंबर। फॉर एग्जांपल, यू कैन सी हियर 2 एंड 3, दे बोथ आर होल नंबर्स एंड 2 + 3 = 5, 5 इज आल्सो अ होल नंबर। सेकेंड प्रॉपर्टी इज कॉल्ड कम्यूटेटिव प्रॉपर्टी, विच वी यूज टू कॉल इट एज ऑर्डर प्रॉपर्टी आल्सो। व्हाई? इफ़ यू चेंज द सीक्वेंस और इफ़ यू रिवर्स द ऑर्डर ऑफ द होल नंबर डिजिट्स, देन आल्सो द थिंग इज गोइंग टू बी सेम, इट इज़ नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज। For example, you can see that 2 plus 3 or rather 3 plus 2, in both the case you will get the answer as 5. That means two whole numbers can be added in the reverse order. Now moving down to the next property number 3, that is associative property, which we used to call it as grouping property. That means if we change the group also, the thing is not going to change. For that we need 3 whole numbers. You can see that 2, 3, 5 are the 3 required whole numbers, in which first we are doing the grouping of 2 plus 3 and then we are getting 5 plus 5, 10. While in the second way, we are doing the grouping of 3 plus 5, in that also case we are getting 2 plus 8, that is 10. So that means if we can group 2 addends out of the 3 in any way, we can make that group. Next is the properties of subtraction, which is opposite of addition. सब्ट्रैक्शन में प्रॉपर्टी नंबर 1 क्या बोलता है? कभी कभी आप दो होल नंबर को माइनस करोगे तो चांसेस है होल नंबर आने की, और कभी चांसेस है नहीं आने की। सो इन मैक्स 50-50 आने के चांस या ना आने के चांस को हम ना ही लेके चलते हैं। फॉर एग्जांपल आप देख सकते हो 8 - 3 = 5, 8 and 3 and 5 ऑल आर होल नंबर। बट वेन वी डू द रिवर्स ऑर्डर, दैट मीन्स 3 - 8, तो हमें -5 मिल रहा है जो कि होल नंबर नहीं है। सो वी से दैट देयर इज़ नो क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी इन सब्ट्रैक्शन। Now moving here towards property number 2, subtraction is not commutative. Why? If you change the order, the answer is not same. You can see, for example, 3 - 2 = 2 - 3. They both are getting the different answers. Continuation in property number 3, subtraction is not associative. Why? If you change the group, then the answer is totally different. You can see that 5, 3 and 2 are whole numbers. When first we are taking the group of 5 and 3, in that way we are getting the answer 0. In second way, we are taking the group of 3 and 2, but in that case, we are getting 4. So the answer is not same. So that's why subtraction is not associative. Now, with all these properties, let's start exercise 2.1. You can see that the statements have been given to us. By seeing the statement, we need to identify the property. Question number 1a, you can see that they are changing the order. Changing the order means addition is commutative. Now in B, you can see that for subtraction, if you change the order, the answer is not equal. So that means we know that subtraction is not commutative. Property number C, you can see that when they are adding the two whole number, we are getting the answer also as whole number. That means it is the closure property of addition. While option number D, 7 - 8 is not a whole number. We know that whole number are not closed for subtraction because the answer is -1 and -1 is not a whole number. Option number E, you can see that they are changing the group. First they are taking the group of 3 and 7, then they are taking the group of 10 and 3. So we know this property, this is associative property for addition. Last, 18 - 9 = 9. Sometimes it happens that when we subtract two whole number, we are getting the whole number. So that's why it is called subtraction is sometimes closed in whole number. Now moving down to question number 2, you can see that by using the commutative or associative property, we need to solve these questions. In the first question, you can see that we need to make a smart group which comes to nearest 10 or 100. So 425 will pair with 75 to become the nearest 100 and 18 will collab with 12. So what, 3 will remain alone. So what we are getting the answer, 425 plus 75 is 500, 18 plus 12 is 30, last but not the least 3, all sum we will get as 533. Now in option number B, 1075 plus 199 plus 25 plus 1. So in this case, what we are going to do, we are going to make a smart pair of 75 plus 25, that is 1075 plus 25 will be one pair, 199 plus 1 will be another pair. So the total will be 1100 plus 200, that is 1300. Option number C, 1238 we will do the smart pairing it with 762, and 2755 we'll make a smart pairing with 3245. On adding up that, we are getting another, that is 2000 plus 6000, and that is 8000. Now coming down to question number 3, you can see that here they are indicating the properties, and by looking the property we need to fill in the blanks. In the very first question, option number 8, 1354 plus 646 equal to 646 plus dash. We know that they are changing the order. This is commutative property. So the answer will be 1354. In option number B, again they are changing the order. It's 5151. So in option number B, we can see that there is a fill in the blanks and they are changing the order. So the appropriate answer is 5151. In option number C, we can see that they are changing the group. This is associative property. So the proper appropriate fill in the blanks will be 529. Option number D also, you can see that again it is a part of associative property. They are changing the group. So the fill in the blanks, the correct answer is 9012. Now in question number 4, they are asking first you do the subtraction, then you verify it by addition. Now you can see that first we need to subtract 1 lakh with 50,000, 55,029. And the answer is 44,971. Now in the next step to verify, we will add 55,029 with 44,971, where we are getting the answer as 1 lakh. Now coming down to the next topic, here also you can see that 2,13,540 subtracted with 34,649. That is 1,78,891. Now we need to add 1,78,891 with 34,649. So we are getting the answer as 2,13,540. Now option number C, you can see that 1,01,010, we need to subtract it with 99,999. We are getting the answer as 1,011. Now we need to add 99,999 with 1,011, and the answer we are getting is 1,01,010. Now question number 5, we need to guess the number. First 3 minus 6, 3 cannot be subtracted with 6, so it will take 1 carry. So 13 minus 6 will be 7, then 9 minus 7 will be 2, then 10 minus 8 again will be 2, 9 minus 5 will be 4. Now here you can see that 10 should be subtracted with what to get 3, we know that 7, and 9 should be subtracted with what to get 1, that is 8. So in this way, we will continue with next option. In option number B, again we can see that 0 cannot be subtracted with 1, so 10 minus 1 is 9, and then 10, it has already given 1 carry forward, so it will become 9. 9 minus what will give you 2, that is 7. Now again here it will become 0, so 10 subtracted with what to get 3, 10 minus 7 is 3. Now here 9 minus 9 is 0, then again we are having 9 minus 2 as 7. Next question number 6, market price is given to us, that is 5620, discount is also given to us 500. If we subtract, we will get the selling price, that is 5120. So selling price is given to us as 5120, profit is given to us, that is 1120. When we are subtracting it, we are getting the cost price, that is 4000. Now in question number 7, the total money was
550,
and the money which she spent is 125 rupees, 250 rupees and 175. On doing the total, 550 rupees in all she spent. Now we know that she was having 550 rupees, in which she spent 550 rupees. So now she has no money with her. The answer is nil.